2020年1月，我们在广州见到了马友友，他和几十位年轻音乐家聚在一起，进行着一场特别的音乐试验。这里没有比赛，没有胜负，几十位来自不同地方的年轻人即将在这里体验另一种全新的接触音乐的方式。
So, and one of the things that I'm hoping that we can do here with everybody over the next 10 days is to do an experiment together. 试验。We're going to have an experiment on how to be joyful, how to be playful, and how to have do very, very deep thinking while being joyful. Are you guys up for that?
Yeah, perfect.
他是世界最知名的大提琴演奏家之一，曾合作过全世界最好的交响乐团和最顶级的艺术家。
Mr. Yo-Yo Ma.
Why am I a musician? If I'm going to be a musician, I have to listen. I have to care. I have to be empathetic. I have to be curious because I end up having to represent people's voices.
他用音乐跨越文化和种族，搭起沟通的桥梁，成为13位联合国和平大使其中之一。
If the world is complete chaos, we are deliberately doing something against our children's future.
4年前，马友友来到广州，成为广东国际青年音乐周的艺术总监。他带着世界知名乐团的10几位成熟音乐家一起，和年轻的学员们在这里相聚。
快乐吗？
快乐！
快乐
！OK， 马上快要过年，对不对？
对。
希望你们大家新年快乐。
10天排练、交流、对话和演出，从早到晚持续进行。马友友选择全程参与。今年他还想利用自己的休息间隙跟每一位学员面对面的交流。我好奇，这样一位世界级的演奏家为什么要做眼前的这些事儿？64岁的他在想些什么，又想做些什么？我们试图在这10天中寻找一些答案。
If you're standing behind someone and you can't see over their heads, step to the front.
It was amazing because I now know who they are, and they know a little bit maybe who I am, but I know who they are because why should I spend, you know, 10 days doing something to talk to a group that's anonymous?
How many students did you talk to?
71. I know where they're coming from. I know what they're worried about. I know what they're thinking about. I know what their challenges are. And, you know, we have 17 people from countries outside of China. We have like about 40 or 35 people who are from China that have not left the country but studied really here. And there's a fair sizable.Number of Chinese people who've actually studied abroad and may have come back or are continuing to study abroad. So we have like 3 groups of people that need to actually all get to know one another and understand each other's experiences while they're doing a lot of things, right? So that's an interesting grouping, but I don't pretend that I know all of them because I also know about them from the faculty members, from the administrators, also from the fellows. And so, you know, it's a growing relationship.
Indeed.
But at least it started.
We're still in the journey of the phrase. It goes.
You're up. So that sound that Michael was talking about is not about da, bong, right? Bong. It's everything is up.
And that exact same idea goes for you guys because it's not da, 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 but it's bong.
What I'm trying to do is an experiment, just like YMCG is an experiment. I feel very strongly the experiment that I'm doing is a listening tour. And what I want to do is to listen to what people have to say in every place.
Why do you have this desire to talk to them, like have a really close conversation to everyone, every single one?
Well, because I'm interested in human beings. Because I know that every human being is different from another person. They may sometimes do the same things, think alike, but they are, by definition, their ears, they hear differently, they see differently, they taste differently, they smell differently. Their experiences are different, right? Truth is very difficult because the truth of you, you know yourself in a certain way, but everybody else who knows you in a different way. So it's like, you know, you're always doing research on actually who you are, and you're also constantly doing research on what the world is. So it's kind of, you have to keep figuring out that balance.
Now here's a cultural image for you to ponder as you listen. A 7-year-old Chinese cellist playing old French music for his new American compatriots. Welcome Yo-Yo Ma and Yu Cheng Ma.
This is 1962年11月29日的一个影像。美国传奇作曲家、指挥家伯恩斯坦将7岁的马友友和姐姐马友成介绍给大家。在这场名为美国艺术盛会的筹款活动中，姐弟俩要为当时的美国总统约翰·肯尼迪夫妇和超过5000名观众演奏。正是从这场演出之后，马友友开始走上年少成名的路。第二年，他就和姐姐登上了卡内基音乐厅的舞台，参加了人生第一场公开演出。
I gotta tell you, honestly, when I was 3, I started on the violin, but I was terrible at it. I screeched.In the way, the worst way that violins can sound when you screech. Because I wanted to, maybe I didn't want to play because my sister played violin, you know. So I gave it up and my parents thought I was not talented for music. And it should have stayed that way. But I made the mistake when I was 4, I saw a very large, very, very large instrument, the double bass. And I thought at age 4, I wanted to play the biggest instrument. And I couldn't. So we had to compromise on the next biggest instrument.
In 1955,马友友出生在法国巴黎的一个中国家庭，父亲马孝俊是音乐教育学博士， 作曲家，母亲卢雅文是一名歌唱家，父母都是中国人。他在法国出生，七岁又和家人一起搬到美国居住。三种文化的碰撞让马友友从小就面临着身份认同的困惑。父母告诉他，中国文化是世界上最好的文化，可他不懂为什么他们要住在法国。搬家时，法国的朋友问他，为什么你们要搬家？到了美国后，人们又说美国是一个伟大的国家。七岁的马友友不能理解，这些都是矛盾的，怎么会每一句话都是对的呢？也许就是从那时起，他想获得一个答案。在音乐周的报名表中，他也曾向学员们提出这样两个问题：我是谁？我如何适应这个世界？
When did you know the answer to this question, and has that changed up to now?
I think sometimes it's more important to ask the question than to have the answer. 为什么？我是谁？世界是什么？ These are questions we have to always ask because, I mean, I open the newspaper from day to day.Our world is changing. Whether it is from the climate change point of view or theories about where the universe is going. Is it expanding? Is it contracting? Is it, you know, where are we in the universe? Those are actually important questions. We just discovered the oldest substance there is, you know, 7 billion years old.And older than the earth, right? So that came from somewhere. And so where did it come from? I think these are questions, and to ask ourselves, we're changing every day, right? Okay, same genes, same genetic material, but between nurture and nature, we're constantly evolving, both as a society, as a human,as, you know, as a community, and humans within our planet. A fire in Australia just killed more than 1 billion animals. That's changed a lot of things. So, I mean, and particularly for people in the expressive arts, because our job is to report on everything that we are and that we have experienced and everything that we feel,both from messages from society, from parents, from teachers, from our peer group, as well as from our own experiments. And so not asking that question actually certainly will make us poorer expressive musicians.
你是谁？你想过什么样的生活？你身处何种困境？人生难题那么多，听听别人的故事，找找自己的答案。这是马友友在广州的社区演出。2018年，马友友开启了为期2年的新征程——巴赫计划。他要在全球36个城市的标志性地点演奏巴赫的无伴奏大提琴组曲。
手跳舞。
下午的第一场演出在珠江边的二沙岛钻石公园。围观的小朋友很多，他们挤到前面想看看大师到底什么样，可马友友却不停地冲着大家做鬼脸，试图逗他们开心。
What did you learn or what do you want from them when you do like the eye contact and the emotional contact?
Well, I think the first thing is connecting.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you and I are a little bit older than these kids. I'm much older than you. But I know as we grow up, we all go through things that we thinkare not that interesting and are even really boring. Oh, I have to sit through this. Okay, fine. You know, 就是我应该做的。You may not be interested, 我应该去做。好，我就去做。But my job, our jobs, are to make things interesting. There's nothing in the world that's not interesting. It's people that make things not interesting and or interesting, right?My wife used to say to our children when they say, we're bored, says, well, you know, there's nothing that's boring. It's like, you're boring. You know, it's like, because until you become interested, you're not interested. Mm-hmm. Until you've made the connection, you're not connected.
Mm-hmm.
And I think, and nobody can connect to everything, but we might want to try to make as much connection as possible to everything,that we can, because in the process of doing that, we're growing.
Up to now, do you have an image about who you are?
Well, I know how much I weigh. I know how, I know what I ate last night. And, you know, I think every era,I think part of being old is actually really interesting because when you're over 60, I can say stupid things and people say, well, you know, 他老了现在说的话说的话完全不了解。
You're taking advantage from
yeah,
that.
Exactly. Or if I say something that is, means something, you say, 这些老头子他还会说几句话还是听到好像有意思。So basically,I feel very free as a person over 60 than when I was 20, when life was very exciting and, you know, I was exploring everything for the first time. But my sense of time then is different than my sense of time now. I have not so many years to live, but actually, if you say 10 years, it's a short time. For a 20-year-old, 10 years is forever.
对于年少成名的马友友来说，青春期是一段充满着困惑和反叛的日子。父亲马孝俊是一个严厉且传统的中国父亲，他教马友友和姐姐说中文，学习中国历史，就连吃饭时也要能说出中文菜名才能动筷。在家里，他和父母很少交流，他被要求服从，把自己的情感隐藏起来。然而在纽约的学校里，马友友适应着另一种不同的文化，老师和同学们期待他开口表达自我，展现个性。在这样两个矛盾的环境中挣扎，他逐渐变得叛逆不安，开始偷偷酗酒逃课，还故意打开琴盒让大提琴淋雨。
When I was growing up, my father, who is very, you know, a very powerful and very brilliant educator, I think said, you know, you must be this, okay? And then he says, but you must also, 一定要听我的话, okay? And I said to him, but you know, father, I can't be a wonderful musician and be completely obedient to you, because part of being a wonderful musician is to know yourself and to declare what you are, what is important. You have to make decisions based on that in order to be true as a musician. I could also listen to you do everything you want me to do, but I actually can't do both.
少年马友友曾经在茱莉亚音乐学院的预科班学习过几年时间，然而还没有毕业，他决定放弃专业的音乐学院，进入哈佛大学学习人类学。他要认识音乐之外的世界。在学校里，他研究生活在卡拉哈里沙漠的布须曼人，也会半夜起来打电话给同学讨论陀思妥耶夫斯基。当今天的马友友看到很多孩子早早地学习音乐，他总是提醒家长们，不要让孩子的世界里仅仅只有演奏。童年与少年是建立情感账户的阶段，要让孩子们存入真正有价值的东西。
You once said we need to create an emotional bank account between 12 to 21. If you have a chance to go back and to put one thing that you think is matters and importance to by now, but you didn't save in your bank account by then, what will it be?
That's very hard to say because I can't put myself in the state of a 12-year-old.In today's world, because, you know, by definition, there's no way I can know. But I don't have regrets. I mean, I have regrets in the sense that we all have regrets, like, oh, I wish, you know, I studied more, or, you know, I wish. No, actually, I don't. I don't have even regrets about that. I think, youth is impatient, you know.That's by definition. But I do know that when you're around 12, you know, it's the age of puberty, puberty changes people because your hormones change, and literally it turns you into a different person, right? Your body changes, you're aware of,the world in a different way. You're separating a little bit from your parents, right? Before it's like, and then suddenly you're trying to figure out a different world, and all the people your own age also are changing at the same time. So that's a very, almost a violent change. You know, your shoes don't fit anymore, your clothing don't fit anymore. You're trying to be attractive to, you know,people you're attracted to, and what does that mean? Suddenly you become self-conscious and you have lots of questions. Who do you trust then? You know, who can give you advice? And today in social media we say, okay, we want peer group, which is really interesting because you have a lot of people knowing what everybody your own age is doing all around the world.
But that's really stressful.
That can create a huge amount of stress.
Yes.
It can also subject you to bullying, which is also terrible, one of the worst things that can happen. But you're also much more aware. So I'm not saying anything is good or bad, but these are the conditions that one has to live with. And what you put into your mind during those years when you're trying to figure things out, I think is part of your emotional bank account. It does, you do draw from that.For the rest of your life. I'm a grandparent now. You know, my grandson is going to be 82 years old in the year 2100. And I think the whole point of having children is to.Prepare them for a world that I'm not going to see. So how do you prepare someone for something you don't know?
Move it!